The solution? Adding the database inside a container. So you spawn it when you want it and trash it when you don't want it, and your computer stay clean. Bonjour, hi. In this video, I will show you how you get a developer database ready to go where you want. Let's get started. When we are developing a new solution, a new project, we don't need yet a full database in the cloud that can scale and everything. We probably just need a database with a few lines of data in there so we can test and program correctly. It's great if the database is centralized, but then every change I do in the data, I could, you know, make the life not that easy for my coworker. So it's cool to have it locally, but then if I install it locally, well, now my computer will be slow because the server is always there. The solution? Adding the database inside a container. So you spawn it when you want it and trash it when you don't want it, and your computer stay clean. This solution will work independently of the OS you're running on and independently of the database you want to use. Today, for example, I will be running on Ubuntu, and the database I'm looking for will be MySQL. Today, all the databases have their official container. So the best place to go, you go on Docker Hub, look for the database you want. Here, for example, it's MySQL. You have the few command line available. So for example, here, if I scroll, I will have some instruction for like how to get the database. And I want to explain that. So let's jump in my notes so we could look at how we create a database. So first, to get that container running, we will use the Docker run. That's very simple. And then we'll give a name to that container. So here, some MySQL. We'll pass the environment variable. So here, I'm using the MySQL root password, and root password, that will give the password for the root. I know it's a very weak password, but it's a temporary environment. I just want to use that so I could, you know, create my script, make sure that everything is okay. And then the important point is we need to map the port. So 3306 is for MySQL, the port that database use, that server use. For another database, it may be a different port. And then I'm just like calling the MySQL, and the dash D here is simply just to say to run in detach mode. So I free up my prompt. So if I execute this in my terminal, let's clear it first, and then I paste it in my terminal. It will go download that image from Docker Hub and run it locally. Great. But now I have the server, but I don't have a database. I don't have any tables, and even less, I don't have any data. So the strategy here is to create some script file that will run every time we spawn the database. If you're a super master of SQL, you don't need to do that part. But you know, since I'm not always play in SQL, what I like to do is create a temporary database, work with a tool like Azure Data Studio to test my script, build my script, my queries, and then save that in a file. When I am sure my script works, then I can trash the database and really work on the solution we'll be using. So now my container is running. If we do a Docker, let's first clean. If I do a Docker PS, I see my container. So now I know my MySQL server is running. So I can connect using different tool. One that I really like because it's cross-platform, so it runs whatever on different machine, and I like to change different computer I'm working from, is the Azure Data Studio. So I'll really share. So like there's a link where you can have the instruction to get that software installed on your machine. And what I also like is there's quick start. So if it's the first time you're using this database for a project, because, you know, from client to client, project to project, we might start using a new database. You don't know yet how to get started with that. So there's a few get quick start with that will really help you. And like, for example, there's one here with MySQL that help us. So I already have installed my Azure Data Studio. So let's go into it. And to be able to connect, so by default, Azure Data Studio is able to connect to to SQL Server, but to get to be able to connect to MySQL, it needs the extension MySQL. So this will be found here in the extension. You just search for MySQL, click the install button, it takes a few seconds and you will be able to do that. Another extension that I really, really enjoy is GitHub Copilot, because then it will help me to write those queries and those scripts. Again, if I'm not like a super master of SQL, I'm rusty a little bit because I just do those time to time, it's really helpful. You will be able to prompt it. Well, I will show you that in a few seconds. I really enjoy that. It's very useful and everything. And if you're interested, there's an episode of Open at Microsoft where they show really a lot of example or how you could use Copilot to help you with your script. I will put all the link in the description, of course. So now what we want is to connect to that database that is running, right? So here we'll just go in the connection and I will click that new connection button. And now I will change. So here it's my Microsoft SQL Server. I want to change it for MySQL. Server name, it's localhost because it's running on my machine, a container. I'm using password. I could be using Azure Active Directory or different thing. The username will be root. And the password here will be the password we put. I think it was root password. Just copy paste that. Set it as to remember. So now every time I will be able to connect. So I don't have any database yet. So I could, like, I cannot specify anything, but we'll create that right away in a few seconds. So now I'm connect. And here I am, I'm connected to my server. And you can see here, there's a few databases that exist, but there's no database for us. So the first things to do is to create a new database. So we'll just create a new database. And here for my project, we'll call that 2d6db. Very original, I know. And voila. So now I have my database. If I refresh, it's here. So now I want to create those query to create first the schema, and we'll have like a two scripts. So one will be the schema creating all the tables I need, and the other one will be data where I will be injecting all the data I need for this. And those two scripts will be executed when we create the database, and that's why the database will always be ready to go. So we'll create a new query. And here, like I said, when you have Copilot and you're not sure how to do that, you could say create adventurer table, and Copilot should make a suggestion. Oh my god. So here we have like a lot of a very complex table. So like you could do many different things in there. I already have something created. So for me right now, I will use something much simpler with just like an ID, a name, a level, and some XP. So I could execute this. So you could again ask Copilot to create some insert statement. So apparently right now it really expects me to do a real adventurer table, but for this demo I'm using a very much simpler version of it. So let me show what I had prepared. And but like the goal here is to have it so you could test your script, make sure it run. Voila. So if I run it, I know it's working. And if I control A, select star from Venture. The beauty also of using the, you could be using the prompt tool of MySQL or multiple database have those prompt tool, but using that tool, the beauty of it is you will have now some intelligence. It's always interesting. So now I see I have like twice Frank. Cool. So I have some data. So this way I can build my script. Obviously, this is 100% optional. If you're a pro in SQL, you don't need to do that. It was just a way to, if you're new to it or like rusty or need a little bit of help, give you some tools here. So once you have your script, you will put, for example, a file called schema.sql, and you will have your description of your table here or all the tables one after the other one, and then you will have a script called data.sql that will have all the insert statement so you can populate those tables. Now we'll stop that container, docker stop some MySQL. Voila. So here what we want is when we start that container, we want it to execute those two scripts. So the best way to do that is to use Docker Compose. So Docker Compose, let me just maximize here the screen. So Docker Compose, usually it's used to have multiple containers and multiple things defined between them. In the solution I'm building on, this is like the first video of a series of video where I want to share how I build my environment and deploy and build script and things like that. So in this first video, I have only one container, but I will still use the Docker Compose because then here I will have, for example, I'm declaring a new service and this container will be called 2d6 server. And just like before, like I'm specifying the image, I have my environment password, I'm specifying the database name here and the root password. I specify the same port. So like this is everything we already saw using the Docker run command. And here the last command is pretty cool because with volume, you could map a folder on your host and on your computer inside the container. And inside the container, I know MySQL because it's in the description. Remember Docker Hub page? It says that it will go check in the Docker entry point initdb and it will look and execute the script in that folder. So that's why I'm mapping here like my schema and my data, and I'm renaming in 1 and 2 because the script will be execute in alphabetic order. So I want to make sure they are, I could have mapped just the folder and make sure I have like alphabetic script, but I decided I want clarity when I'm on the dev side and I want something efficient when I'm in my container. So 1, 2, it's pretty obvious. So now when I will execute my Docker Compose command, it will create just like before that database and then execute the schema. So create the tables and then insert the data inside of it. To do that, we'll use the Docker Compose command. And if you have multiple Docker, so by default, Docker Compose will search for a Docker Compose.yaml file. If you have multiple, I have in my dev environment, that's why I'm using the F. So I could specify, okay, just start just the database, start the database with the API, start the database with API in like my dev environment. So I could have like multiple containers start, so I have different file. So like, or if for you Docker Compose mean nothing, you prefer having something, just use dash F and then up. So it's Docker Compose up will execute this, bring that up. And again, the dash D parameter here is to make sure we're freeing up the prompt. Otherwise, you will see all the execution. It's cool when you want to debug something is not working, but otherwise it's just, you know, annoying because you have all that. So now if I do Docker Compose up, it'll create, it will start. Obviously to execute and be ready, it takes a few seconds. It could take longer if you have a lot of SQL command to execute, but here it should be pretty quickly. So now if I go back here inside my queries, let's cancel. Don't save, bing, bang. We'll create a new query. I will connect to 2d6. Connect. Want to use the same from before, but now I can connect to 2d6 server. And now if I run my query, in my script, I add two different user and it was not Frank and Frank. So let's check if that worked. So we'll execute this. So see, now we have Toby the creator and Frank. So I have to data, so it really worked. And when I'm done and want to free up my computer, I just need to run, let's go back to my history. I just need to, it doesn't need to be capital. Let's rewrite it without yelling. So Docker compose down again with the parameter F, if you have a specific name, voila. And who says a development phase needs to add more data, maybe change some table structure and things like that. So what you need to do is go back in your SQL script here, make the change and do a Docker compose restart, and it will, you know, delete everything and spawn it again. And this way you will have a database ready to go when you want, always fresh, without any latency, without being worried about, you know, making the life of your coworker hard because you're just delete all the user or like drop all the product or whatever. You will have a simple database ready to go when you want to go. In my next video, what I want to show is how I use the Azure Data API Builder to scaffold a full API on top of my database and still use that Docker compose command to have my full environment whenever I want. Stay tuned for more.